Before we go into how virtual memory works, let's first see why do we even want to have virtual memory. And the short answer is that we want to have virtual memory because the programmer and the hardware have different views of what memory means. In the hardware view, the machine has some memory modules with an actual amount of memory that can be accessed by the real processor. Let's say that this module is 2 gigabytes and this module is 2 gigabytes. So what the hardware really has is 4 gigabytes of memory, and the addresses for these 4 gigabytes are going to be 0 through 4 gigabytes. In contrast, the programmer's view of memory is that it's a huge array with addresses that go from 0 to a very, very large number if it's a 64-bit machine. This is many, many gigabytes. Obviously, this is much more than what the machine really has. Some of this memory might be reserved for the system. Some of this memory contains the actual program instructions. Some of it is for static data. Then we have the memory for the heap, which is where malloc finds its memory, and this heap can grow. And then some of it, usually very high in the memory address space, is the stack, and that typically grows this way. But the programmer doesn't really want to be bothered by how much space is there between the heap and the stack. What they want to do is simply malloc or push things on the stack, and they never run out of memory. And in a 64-bit address space, chances are they won't actually run out of memory. But the problem is the actual amount of memory that they're using might be less, or it might be much more than the actual memory that the machine has here. Things are actually much more complicated because we typically don't run only one program on a machine. We actually are simultaneously having multiple programs run. You might be having something that browses files here, an MP3 player playing in the background, and a word processor here. Each of these sees the address space that begins at 0 and ends at a very large address. We don't want to write our programs so that this needs to run as the first program in the system, this needs to run as the second program in the system. You want to write the program as if it was the only program in the system, and then just run multiple programs like that. But that means that this program's idea of memory is it thinks it has all of this memory. This program similarly thinks it has all of this memory. So as far as these two programs are concerned, for example, their code might well be at the same address in each program, although in fact they have different instructions at those addresses. So virtual memory is a way of reconciling how the programmers view memory and how the hardware actually needs to view memory in order to work.